This is your cooking doctor, Kamal Mehta. Now today, friends, I'm going to show you a Parsi dish called Papetama Ghosh. So without any delay, let's start with the procedure. I've put a pan to heat with high flame. Now in this, we add 500 grams of mutton. And now to this, we will add, I have taken 3 chopped fine onions, finely chopped. So I add this also at this stage only with the mutton. Along with this, I will add 3 finely chopped tomatoes. Now all this has to be put together. As you have seen, I have not added any oil or ghee at this stage. I have just added the mutton, the tomatoes and the onions. And now I will add 2 full tablespoons of adrak lasun paste, that is ginger garlic paste. You can either freshly ground it or take Dabur's ready-made garlic ginger paste. And to it, I will add 2 tablespoons of biryani masala. Yes, my friends, you have heard right. Biryani masala. I shall be adding this in this. And now I will let this whole thing saute itself and leave it till all the water dries up and the meat is totally dried up. Till then, we shall not add any oil or ghee into it. Now, we shall leave this for it to fully dry up. It will take around 10 to 15 minutes for it to totally dry down. Now, as you can see, the water is getting dried and it's coming out. You can see this. And now, this will have to totally dry up. Till then, you have to let it saute. Okay, now as you see, all the water has dried up. The onion has left its water, the meat had left its water, and everything has totally dried up. As you can see, totally the meat is dried up. Now at this stage, I will add 2 teaspoons of ghee and 2 teaspoons of oil. Now as you can see, I have added only 2 teaspoons of oil and ghee, but more the merrier. If you add more, it will be more tastier. Now after this, we will again saute it for 1 minute. We'll mix all the oil properly into the meat so that each piece is coated well. Now to this, I will add all my masalas. I have taken 2 teaspoons of red chili powder. You can take more according to your taste of spiciness, as much you want. Taken 2 teaspoons of sambar Parsi masala. Now my friends, this is not the same sambar masala of your South Indian dishes. This is a Parsi masala which you will get in Bombay, and if you don't have it, it's optional. And I'm putting 1 teaspoon and 1/4 teaspoon of garam masala. Now after adding all this, I'll give it a quick stir. As you can see, all the masala has for 2 minutes. See, it's become nice and brown in color, and we shall do it more. Nice aroma has started coming also of the roasting of the meat. Now we'll continue this for around 10 minutes and then we shall add water into it and then put it into the cooker. It does not stick to the bottom. Either you take a heavy bottom pan or a non-stick pan and keep scraping it from down such that it does not stick. Now when you've seen it is nicely red and roasted, absolutely the color that we require. On this video maybe you will not see the exact color, but it will turn dark brown color. To it we will add, first we will add 1 cup of water, then we will add another cup of water, so total 2 cups of water. We have used the cake measuring cup. And now let it go into a boil and then we shall put it in our cooker. Seeing that the boil has come onto it, so now we will just put off our flame and we will transfer this into our cooker. More of water, and now we shall close the cooker and put it on high flame for 5 whistles, and then we will lower the flame and put it around for 25 minutes. After that we will open it and see whether the meat is done. If not, we will again put it for another 10-15 minutes. This is what I have done. I have taken it out from the cooker and again put it in our pan, and now this is how it will look in the final stage. Nice, red, tempting, tested and tasty recipe of mine. Now to this we will add around 4 boiled potatoes. Now optional it is that either you fry the potatoes after boiling it, or you just add it as in how it is, or the third option is also you can add it directly into the cooker whilst the meat is done in the last 15 minutes before shutting the cooker off. Now we will let it simmer for around 10 minutes more such that the potatoes take up the juices taste a little. My Papitarma goes. If you have liked it, please share and subscribe it. And this is my tried and tasty recipe. Thank you.